posted April 26, 2018, 7 hours 56 minutes and 4 seconds, just a few weeks into the AFL season, a cloud has been cast over the reputation of the newly unwrapped Perth Stadium thanks to public criticism of one of its key aspects, the turf. West Australians were repeatedly promised a world-class stadium for their $1.8 billion investment. It will never be that unless stadium management can get the fundamentals right, like the playing surface. The issue is made worse coming after Geelong players Zach Touhy and Mark Blicavs were cut on the LED fence surrounding the ground. Maintaining the surface at shared-use facilities presents challenges. Sydney's Olympic Stadium and Docklands are examples of this. But we were told Perth Stadium would be different, world-class, locally grown turf chosen for Perth Stadium playing surface. It was proofed in a statement from the previous Barnett government back in September 2016. The playing surface for the 60,000-seat stadium is a hugely important element of the project, not only helping players to perform at their best but also providing fans with a great viewing experience too, former Premier Colin Barnett said at the time. A tried and tested solution has been selected accommodating different sporting and entertainment events, but so far, the surface at Burswood hasn't been up to scratch. A litany of injuries, clubs and players are reporting it is too hard. While all injuries can't be directly related to the turf, there has been a high number of leg injuries in the first six games of the season. Gary Ablett and Torrey Dixon have both done hamstrings, Lance Franklin and Matt Taberner have sustained foot injuries, Liam Ryan, Daniel Venables and Cam Guthrie have serious ankle issues, Luke Shuey is also battling turf toe. Compare that to the first six games at Subiaco Oval last year, when the injury list consisted of Stephen Hill, hamstring, and Sam Mitchell, ankle. It is a new stadium, a new turf obviously, and we think more work can be done to improve that, Fremantle chief executive Steve Rosich admitted. The excuse that it is a new surface and takes time to bed in is the line being used. But with the amount of planning that went into the stadium and the long lead in time, the surface should be up to standard. The lessons from Docklands and Sydney's Homebush Stadium should have been learned. A question of turf. The issue isn't the type of turf because the same turf is used at Perth Oval and the MCG, probably two of the best surfaces in the country. So, if it is not the type of turf being used, the question needs to be asked, is it being managed properly? The stadium operator has finally acted and stopped teams training on the ground for the next 3 weeks, with the aim of finding a solution during that period. You only have to look at Docklands to see the type of brand damage an inadequate surface can bring. It could be argued the ground's reputation has never quite recovered. Docklands is still very hard and players injured on the ground struggle to recover. But right now, it is not the hardest surface in the AFL, that title now belongs to Perth Stadium. The stadium is still in a grace period. But if these issues continue, the world-class stadium WA was promised may never be realized. It is all good having nice lights and stunning views, but if you can't get the fundamentals right then none of the rest matters. Topics: Australian Football League.